What's up guys, it's Fergie here, and today I'm going to be talking to you about the Arch-Paladin class. Now, this was the class that was used to finalize the Throne of Darkness storyline, which was the storyline designed by artist everyone loved, which released so many classes, and Arch-Paladin was by far the most used and the strongest of all of the classes we released. So, without further ado, let me show you how to get to join Dark Throne Hub. Get the class. Now once you're here, you can't see your character, but you click on Arch Paladin, then current paladins for members. They're just some quests. I've already done them and they've gone. Then paladin recruits are for people who just non-members who don't have paladin class. Then once you're done with everything, you get the class from Arch Paladin, then shop. Then get the class for free, or you can get it for 2k aces. You can also get this the cape and all of those other cool items. So let's jump into the stats of the class. Same attack and spell power, which means it's obviously a hybrid, and which signifies luck enhancement. Same strength and intellect, same endurance and dex, low wisdom and terrible luck, but the luck is seriously boosted, as you can guess, luck enhancement. Gains mana the good way relative to health, which is just a up plus for this class. I think the rank 10 passive is a 15% damage resistance. I'm not 100% sure, but that's what most classes have now. First rank 4 passive, restitution, reducing incoming damage by 20%. Maybe the rank 10 passive may be a damage output, I'm not sure. Overwhelming light, your heals are 20% more potent. Wow. So as you can see, even the passive show the greatness of the class. So that being seen, I said let's go to pirates. Now it's okay if you don't see your character here, that's just the way the map was designed, and there's only one person per room, so have that at the back of your mind. So Arch-Paladin is a very fun class, very powerful class, one of the strongest classes in Adventure Quest. The auto attack is the stronger version, a strong attack known only to disciplined fighters. Now I don't think this affects the damage, just a description. 1.2k crit, 400 non-crit, as simple as that. Your rank 2 skill, your 2 skill is called Commandment, 10 mana, 5 second cooldown, physical magical skill, attack using a weapon infused with the power of light, dealing moderate damage to 3 enemies. Your opponent is commanded by the light and has 2% less damage, 2% less dodge chance, 2% less crit chance, 2% less crit amount, 2% less hit chance, and take 2% more damage. Last 100 seconds and stacks up to 50. You also receive a small damage over time, which stacks to 5, deals bonus damage to undead. So at max stack, you reduce your opponent's damage by 100%, dodge chance by 100%, crit chance by 100%, crit amount by 100%, hit chance by 100%, and then the person takes double damage. So as you can see, a very strong class. I love the animation with the blinding light. 4k crits without any stacks, 5k crits. As you can see, very powerful, potent skill, easily spammable, just 5 second cooldown, and it does the damage. Now mind you, these are undead, so it does more damage to them, but against the normal monsters it's still a pretty high amount. This skill is called Hymn of Light, 40 mana, 10 second cooldown, physical magical skill. A forgiving light encompasses you and up to 5 allies, heals for a moderate amount, and increases endurance and defense by 20% for 6 seconds. Now this is a skill that I say can never ever fully heal you. Why? Just watch my health bar. As you can see, this happens because it increases my endurance after healing me. So you have to wait for your health to automatically go up. If not, that's just the beauty of the skill. But nevertheless, it takes you to full normal health, but the endurance increase just pushes that up a bit too. It's a very strong heal, as you can see, 2.4k non-crit. It should crit for about 8 or 9k, which is just irrelevant, but it helps in blood rot. So first skill is called Righteous Seal, 30 mana, 15 second cooldown, physical magical skill. Using holy magic, you temporarily seal you and up to 3 of your opponent's power away. deals moderate damage, but then this is all damage you will do by 50%, all damage your opponent will do by 90% for 10 seconds. As you can see, this is a very beautiful skill. My they were hitting about 70 crit, now 12 crit, but my damage is also halved. So as you can see, the class is all about tanking. One of the passives reduces damage, this reduces damage, and your first skill also reduces damage, which is just potent for soloing. And you can actually do without this skill unless you are soloing strong bosses, which this skill comes in handy. But nevertheless, against regular bosses you may not need it, but PvP is a lifesaver. Your five skills cost Sacred Magic Eden, 70 mana, 35 second cooldown. Whew. Magical skill, this massive damage buffed by the stacks of deity from commandment, capping out at 5 stacks. Consume stacks of commandment, you become exhausted and can't give stacks of commandment for 8 seconds. Has a 20% chance to stun undead for 3 seconds. So this stun is called Undermine Stun, but I don't think you'll see it here because it's going to off all of them. So let's see. Without any stacks, 3.4k non crit and a 12k crit on him. So enough said, it's just a nuke based on stacks of commandment which you get from here. It also applies commandment consumed on you, which means you won't be able to stack commandment for a while, kind of like Cryomancer and new tiers. So let's get some stacks of commandment and see, because this skill is a very powerful skill. You see the full power of this class in the solo. Now Arch Paladin is a very slow class, but it deals lots of damage to multiple opponents. So if you are in a room full of undead, just have fun. As you can see, 7k crit, and I'm not applying commandment on Captain Obed because I'm exhausted. But enough being said, you can see the power of this class. That 7k will crit for about 20 something k. So already High Paladin is showing how much of an OP class it is. The class is very easy to farm. The only tricky part is some 1% 27k, some 1% drops that you need for the quests, but they are only about, I think, 7 or so quests, which you can complete in a day with devotion, but a maximum of 3 days. Now if you need help, you can always catch me on the Arctic server. I'll gladly help you farm the class. So enough being said, for your enhancement, use full lock. As you can see, weapon, helm, class, and cape lock. Before you start farming, you are going to need rank 10 good, and then if you want to get my axe, rank 10 mysterious dungeon. They are both pretty easy to farm, especially the good. You can get decent amount from some quests, but enough being said, you figure it out when you're about to farm. So this is all for the guide. I'll play the solo clip for you guys as usual. Until next time, I've been Figure Out. Love you guys, peace.